Opposition MDC Alliance leader Nelson Chamisa says his arch-rival, President Emmerson Mnangagwa, has done a perfect hatchet job by removing bad apples in the opposition party. The outspoken politician made the remarks Monday while appearing on the Number Mamanimande's show, discussing democratic developments happening in Africa. Poster. Chamisa was referring to his erstwhile colleague Douglas Mwenzora and other former senior opposition politicians who have openly joined ZANU-PF, or the MDCT led by Mwenzora. Number Mamanimande's is hosted by South Africa opposition leader Musi Maimane. Since year early 2020, Chamisa has lost scores of senior party officials, including MPs, to the ruling ZANU-PF, or the MDCT. This is after the Supreme Court ruled Chamisa was not the rightful leader of the MDCT. Notable figures who have deserted him include Elias Mutsuri, Mwenzora, Morgan Kamichi, Lilian Timvius, Blessing Chibundo, Tongai Matutu, Tupiwa Mashakata, Porina Mbarua, and Bulawayo Mayor Solomon Mguni. However, Chamisa described the politicians who have crossed the floor as good riddance. "We understand that we have been affected by what Mr. Mnangagwa has been doing, but thank God. Mr. Mnangagwa has done a fantastic thing for us," said Chamisa. "He has managed to reorganize us MDC Alliance by taking away from us the bad elements and bad apples and bad elements. All dictatorships thrive on the appetite and greed of the oppressed and the vulnerabilities of those who are active in politics. And our basket of good apples is sure to provide that hope to the people of Zimbabwe. Yes, we have seen a lot of people being invited to the feeding trough because of opportunities narrowing. Most of the people are then invited to be part of the gravy train, but this is where a principled leadership works, and this is where conviction creeps in, and we have been building our leadership around convictions, to say our duty is to be motivated by the missionary zeal, not the mercenary zeal." Chamisa added, "So, that has been a big fight. You will always have in a struggle those who get tired, those who get exhausted, and those who decided to pitch camp with the oppressor. But just that is to remind us that it's a struggle." He went on to urge Zimbabwean youths to register to vote ahead of the 2023 watershed national elections. "Young people, I know you can do it. Let's go out there to register to vote, and not just register to vote, but also to engage meaningfully in the discourses of the day around bread and butter issues, around moving our nation from poverty to prosperity. That move to prosperity is your move. You are the movers and shakers. You are the game changers. The game is on. The end game is coming, and change is coming to Zimbabwe. The Federation of Democracy is consolidated. We stand guided with Malawi. It went to Zambia. It will come to Zimbabwe. I can feel it. The sweet smell is just coming through. It will then also engulf entire Southern Africa, South Africa included. Happiness and joy for the people of our continent is going to be our portion. It is certain that victory shall come and be our time."